28th, 2017, here at Town Hall. And roll call, John Anderson? Yeah, John Reynolds?
Present.
Present. John Anderson?
Joe Anderson, present.
Looking at one of you, calling the other name.
My father's name is John Anderson. He's not here.
All right. That's good. I'm glad you're here. Okay, and Carl Luck, present. In accordance with the requirements of the open meeting law, please be advised that this meeting is being recorded and broadcast over Lunenburg Public Access. Announcements, have one announcement, which is that our latest member, Richard St. Cyr, joined us, has had to resign. He's taken a position in a warmer climate, a new job in a warmer climate, and is unfortunately leaving Lunenburg. And we will miss him and all of the many years of experience he had with sewer systems. We wish you luck, Richard. So that also creates my second announcement, which is we now have an opening on the Sewer Commission. And we would encourage anyone who's interested to either fill out a talent bank form that's available at Town Hall or online, or contact any one of us, including Barb at the DPW, if you'd like to talk about it or learn more about what we do. And then I guess the other announcement is the caucus, which is probably later on here anyway, but Town Caucus is coming up, and Barb will hit that later in the meeting. So we have no appointments. Looks like we have no public comment. Is there any public comment from the commission?
No.
No? Okay. Moving right along, then. The big event of the evening is hopefully trying to finalize our budget submittal. We've reviewed it at our meeting 2 weeks ago. I've had one offline working session with Barb, and we'll go through that right now. It's sent out today. Everybody has a copy. What suggest we do is go through primarily the things that have changed since our meeting 2 weeks ago. And of course, if there's anything else that has occurred to anyone in the meantime, please speak up. We'll just go right through the not every line, but we'll go in the order of the lines. And the first section, we'll go through. I'll pull this up on the screen, and I'm not sure if anyone at home can actually read that or if we can zero in on that sufficiently to be read, but I hope so. Maybe on a big screen TV it's better, I don't know. So the orange highlighted areas are the areas that were either modified or discussed in the interim of the 2 weeks here. So I'll focus on those. But again, anyone who has any other comments outside of those, please bring them up. Our goal tonight is to hopefully be able to vote on a final budget that we would then present to the Finance Committee on the 9th. And then, presuming that goes well, take to town meeting on May 6th or
7th.
Okay. That's Saturday. Okay. So the first item of importance is a transfer from the stabilization fund that it was set up last year at town meeting. And that was basically set up because we were not able to spend all the money we had allocated on inflow and infiltration work because we hadn't had the reports and didn't have time to get that work going. So we've carried into this year using the stabilization fund, and so we will be planning to transfer that $14,520 back out of stabilization because we have plenty of work to do and can use that. The next one we probably need to talk about a little bit, because we may want to make a different decision on this. This shows transferring the stabilization funds that we have for reserve capacity. This was to these are basically the fees that we've been collecting when people connect to the system to support our purchase of capacity. Initially, that's the John Fitch Highway expansion that we have to fund would be to support that. That, Fitchburg has not yet finalized that work and that cost, so they have not passed those costs on to us. We've been carrying line items that would cover that every year so far. But we might want to talk about the transfer of this amount of money or not, because if we have the same situation and Fitchburg doesn't come to us for the money, then what's going to happen if we transfer this out of the capital capacity fund is that at the end of the year, we're just going to have to put it back into the capacity fund, or else it'll go into retained earnings, which wouldn't be a good thing. So I probably flipped 180 degrees on your bar, but my current thinking is that we don't take that out at town meeting in May.
Special town meeting.
And if Fitchburg does come ask us for our money, it won't be immediately anyway, then we could go back at special town meeting to pull this out. And would make a lot more sense. It would be a fairly straightforward thing. We'd tell the town that, okay, we've got the bill, we've got this money, let's take it back out of the bank.
And they just approve it because it's our money anyway, right?
Right. So what would the feeling be on that?
I'm okay with that.
So let's pull that back out. It's offset below anyway.
No risk.
So it doesn't actually change the bottom line, because down in expenses, it's put back in as an expense, so it balances out. So this doesn't really change our bottom line budget.
I would say yes.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Head back. No sense having to move it twice if you don't have to.
Right. Yeah, and I'd hate to, you know, have Fitchburg send us a bill just because they saw us take this out.
They don't get this channel.
No, they don't. Okay. The other orange item is the sewer bank I&I fees. I don't think that this number changed from the original, or maybe it changed slightly.
It got corrected.
It got corrected. But this is basically what we're assuming we'll collect during the year when people connect. So, Barb, helping on this one. Is this
there are 11 connections.
Is that based on history?
Based on, is that
like the average is a...
Yeah, we're going with a three-bedroom home.
I mean, just connections in general.
Oh. Every year we use a different number. Like different, last year we used 20 because we had the new betterments. So we figured, okay, there's going to be a bunch of people jump on.
So it's just kind of a best guess type situation.
Right, yes. That's in line.
Yeah. Okay. So, but it's a good point, Joe, because the assumption of new connections ripples through this whole thing in several areas. So
if we don't get those connections, what happens?
If we don't get those, well, for every connection we get, we've got to pay. So, and there is a slight offset, not
so if we don't get them, it doesn't hurt us. If we get more than 11, it does?
If we get more than 11, it helps.
It helps.
Because we pay less than we receive. If we get less than 11, it'll hurt a little bit because we pay less than we receive, so we're counting on receiving a little bit more than we pay.
So 11, a good number to put in there. Pretty good. I assume you guys talked about that, the offline thing.
Yeah, just generally. I mean, we're looking for almost half of that from the new SRF properties.
Okay.
Yeah. It would be good to know, Barb, right a second, unless you happen to know it, but for the presentation of finance, of how many of the 90-something we assume have connected, so that'll help calibrate as viable, aggressive number or not aggressive.
The 90 of the SRF?
Yeah, okay. The SRF, so we know where we are on that one.
Is that something they generally ask, like, hey, you say 11, do you...
They might well ask, just as you did, where, you know, why 11? I suspect if we go back, we probably seldom had a year that was less than 11, even in total.
Right. Well, right.
I mean, 11 is not a high number. I just didn't know where it came from.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah. We've had a Emerald case. We've had a lot. Stone Farm. There's been a lot going. Right now, there's not a lot of churn.
Right.
So,
I guess another calibration is these numbers, Barb. I think we have about 840 or something connections now,
mm-hmm.
and like 1,200 or so people that abut a line that can connect.
400 more.
About 400 more, yeah, 1,200 total that abut lines. So we've got two-thirds of who has a line in front of their house connected now, so there's a pretty good population of places, and a lot of times when a house transfer, they'll switch from, if they still have their septic, they'll switch over.
Yeah.
So I think 11 is a pretty conservative number.
Yeah, sounds like it. So there's 1,200 that could do it. Okay.
Okay. Grease trap permit fees. This was basically updated, as we had talked about at the meeting, with the actual people who were going to get non-compliance permit versus a full compliance permit as of today. So if anyone else goes non-compliant for the rest of the year, then this will go up a little bit. It should not go down from this.
No.
So in a way, but I can't imagine. It's pretty low risk.
Goes out of business.
Well, let's hope not.
All right, the next one, high field capacity. This we've taken a little different strategy to help simplify this whole thing. We had the agreement with Highfield, the signed agreement we have, because they had to buy capacity because they didn't have capacity for that development. So they signed up for to pay us $57,000 and change up front immediately when we send them the bill. We had historically been carrying that whole income here and then removing it below so that it didn't look ridiculous, because we won't use it all at once, obviously. What we did, we decided that's just more confusing than it has to be. So what we've done is taken the 1/20th, because this is over 20 years, 1/20th of that $57,000 as real income.
2885.
Which is the 2886. And again, that zeroes out below, and when we get to expenses, there'll be the expense for that. And I think that's okay to carry here because that keeps some visibility to it.
Good.
Reserve capacity fund is just as new connections come online, and I believe that 3086 represents 5 out of the 11 would be
paying a capacity fund.
It's not everybody that connects has to pay that fund. If you paid a betterment for the first on the first phase, if you paid a betterment, there was capacity allocated to you for that betterment. That's sort of part of what you get for the betterment. You not only get the right to connect, but you were assured capacity. It's why we had to go buy capacity, because we see people that have a right to connect. They didn't pay betterments, but they have a right to connect. And there was no capacity for them. So that's why it's only 5 of 11. So again, the risk is, it's pretty low, hopefully. And it's like $617 per household. So the risk is relatively low. So the net total revenue then comes in at this $843,833. Any other comments or?
So it's 44 less?
Yes, from our last one. And a lot of that is the high fields. That was 54,000, I think.
Yeah, so that's a good point, Barb. So in order to make it apples and apples, you'd have to add 57 of that. So it's actually the difference between 57 and 44 more than last year. Remember, we pulled out the 57 that was shown here, but then subtracted below.
Mm-hmm.
So it looked like revenue, but it also looked like cost. So when you see our costs go down, it's the same thing there. They partially went down because of the 57,000. So if you net that out, it's roughly $7,000. It's a percent. It's not much of an increase. But you wouldn't expect it to increase much with only 11 new connections? Because our rates are not going to change. We're assuming roughly people use the same amount of wastewater. So you wouldn't expect much more income because you don't have any growth.
There's only one thing changed down here in payroll. That's the minutes.
Yes.
They got a raise.
They did.
They haven't started yet. How'd that happen?
Yeah.
How do you get raises before you get in there?
Only in municipal government can that happen.
Well, good for them.
That clerk is under salary admin plan, and I guess at a special town meeting in November, they passed a new grid.
So that bumped it.
And the grade and step that she'd already been told was for this position. Got a bump.
All right. Well, good for them.
Yeah. Fortunately, so I can sleep at night, it's only like $200 or something impact.
It's not coming out of your pocket, relax.
It's all coming out of my pocket.
All right. There you go.
Comes out of John's pocket, which even worries me more. Okay. So. Purchase of services. This is a lot more activity down here.
Mm-hmm.
Year over year, if infrastructure year over year, it's actually gone up 5,000. Pump station equipment, and the infrastructure is basically what the operation, what Jack gets to work with. In terms of emergency repairs and doing things that just need to get done. So
can you, can you actually make that larger so we can see what that says?
Yes.
Or is it down here maybe?
You want column B? What?
Yeah, so.
You've got some hidden columns there. So.
I've got hidden columns, but.
It just says includes generators and wet wells.
Just includes generators and wet wells.
Yeah, let me just click on it so you can read it on the top.
Okay.
All right. Yeah, ask me the other one because I don't know how to increase that with the
That's fine.
Frozen frames. So we've got 10,000 in the equipment line item, the 10 for jetting, which is the historic number and always seems to cover us, and then some.
So irrigation meter replacement got lined out?
Yes. I was reading the wrong line there. Yeah, we had some discussion on that. This was, for the sake, there's about 80-ish customers that have irrigation meters. They're all manually read, I'll call them, physically read. They're not electronically read like the water district has gone to. And we've talked about, and hopefully we can come together with a plan to get people to start using electronic reads and then perhaps convert the other. There was a suggestion or proposal by Jack that we replace those with people have them. Those were never purchased by the enterprise fund, quite frankly. They were purchased by the individuals. The discussion was that it really didn't feel it was appropriate for all of the users to pay for those 80 people to get new meters. So we still think we want to proceed to do that. We need to talk about how to do that.
How to buy them new meters?
I don't know whether we should buy them. I mean, one thing we have historically drawn a line on is we don't buy equipment for people.
Yeah, I wouldn't do that.
Right.
So then you have to replace them and fix them and maintain them.
Yeah, well, when they break, when they don't read right, whatever. That. So if we did find some way to help them, I think it would have to be through some revenue stream from the users of them. So there's a lot of discussion that had to be had on it, but we felt that it wasn't right.
So we don't need to talk about it during the budget meeting then?
No.
So we just X that out, make it zero, yep. And then that'll be an agenda item for another day.
How do we get there?
how do we at least maybe change our regulations so that people can actually buy the right meter?
Sure.
How do we would have to fund the reader for it, which is not insignificant. So that could be a budget item next year, if you find a way to do this. So there's a lot of discussion to be had, but the feeling was that right now, it's not really appropriate budget item.
I think it's something we should keep visible and start the discussion.
Yeah.
Yeah, we should make it an agenda item for an upcoming, maybe after the budget stuff.
Yes. The next line, the 10,000 meter pit flows, we've increased that to 10. That's what the quote is to move the two-way meter that we use going to Fitchburg. This is the meter that Fitchburg measures by. We've had trouble with the reliability of that because the electronics is in the pit. So we need to move it back out of the pit.
So where's the money for the police detail come from, if that's not included?
Those usually come out of infrastructure.
Okay.
That's where purchase of service is all one big umbrella account that where we go outside for service or infrastructure. And that's usually where details come from.
Joe, I don't know if you know the history about that meter. It used to be out on the side of the road, you know, in a cabinet, and it was hit by a car.
No.
Damaged.
I didn't know that.
The quickest way to get it working again was to put it in the manhole, but it's not the best place for it. Not on that road.
Yeah. It was recommended, but then by engineers, because it would be safe and we wouldn't have to deal with it again. But the problem that we're finding from flow assessment that goes out is the condensation from being underground is just destroying the components. So their recommendation is to get it back up above.
That's 10K, huh?
Yeah.
Jesus.
I'm not sure why the next line, the system upgrades, $1,000 is orange.
System upgrades. It was, I thought it was 2,000.
Oh, we reduced it to
one.
Okay.
That's all.
That was so long ago, it seems.
Yeah.
Okay, so that actually went down. Okay, so the total for infrastructure is 32,000. Primarily up from the 27 because of that meter replacement into the pit. Okay, INI remediation. We had at the last review some details under that. We have a number of proposals and a number of discussions. We felt that at this point, since we don't know exactly how we're going to use the money, we got rid of the detail. So, the 50,000 is the same number we had talked about that we feel is a good number for next year. For anyone at home, historically, we've spent about $30,000 a year.
Mm-hmm. And this year we're doing more.
But this year we need to do more. We now have some work identified, the manhole work.
Right, this is all that stuff with the gaskets and the
manhole, yeah. Gaskets, some cammering, some, you know, we've got more to choose from than 50,000 to support in any one year. But we also have that 14,000 we're taking out from the stabilization fund that helps us here, that's part of that 50. So out of the operating fee-based budget, we're still around 30,000. So we haven't.
That's usually what we're usually at, right?
We're usually at 30 is what we usually have. Last year we underspent that a bit because we got a grant.
The 16.8 was last year.
Exactly.
What was the grant for? How much was the grant for?
30,000.
That's cool. Okay.
Outsourcing is the contract for the pump station contract is a fixed amount. This is the second year of a three-year contract.
Yes.
And that includes the generator maintenance. So that's all the small water. Grease trap outsourcing. We've always said that our
our goal is to have the grease trap program with the restaurants be break-even. So all we've done here is we've taken the income that we projected above and put that down here so that we have money that, because we're responsible now for inspection of the interceptors outside and, you know, there's, you know, lots of things if we can figure out how to get somebody to help us. So this is some good seed money.
The number, you think, good? Seems conservative. You're going to be getting people outsourcing to do these things.
You know, depends on what you do. We went around, and that's why, you know, Jack finally said, look, let me get out in the field. I'll see what's going on and see if I can get things squared away to a certain point that we can get a realistic quote on what we need, because it's hopefully not the $20,000 quote we got. It may not be $6,000 to outsource everything, but maybe everything can't be outsourced. So
right.
It's a good target. It's a good number that we can use. We know where it's coming from. We know it'll break even. It won't cost the residents any money out of pocket if we stick to this number. And if we can you know, get some of the load off Barb, especially some of the administrative load, that would be a plus.
Okay.
Billing outsourcing, this is, you know, a big known unknown whether we can do it or not. We do have some rough quotes. They ranged from 20 to 30,000, and this is through the same contractor that does the billing for the water district. The data that we use for our billing comes from the water district, so it's the same data. So there is an advantage, a cost advantage, if we could work through the water district. So we have two quotes from Northern, who is their contractor, and they range from, you know, roughly 20 to 30,000. So 25,000 is a ballpark. We may not be able to, you may not be able to do it, may not make sense. We may come to a decision that it's not worth it. It may take us most of the year to work out the details. So I think of that 20, I forget the upfront is, I think a little over 20 for the upfront cost. So you may well, due to timing and figuring out what to do, you may find that you only get to do the NRE up front, and then you start the billing next year. But it's there if we can pull this off. It's there to use. Otherwise, what'll happen is if we don't use it, and everything else happens as we said, it'll just fall back to retained earnings. Which is if this was zeroed out, that's where we'd go on day one. So it's basically just holding back some of those retained earnings to give us the opportunity to go outsource some of this work so Barb can get more done and more time to actually think.
Yeah, how long does it take now, Barb, to do the billing? I think we talked about it before. It's like a giant chunk of time, right?
It is, but it's there's a lot of that goes into it. Yeah. So it's several weeks, but...
You sure you want to give it up?
That's the problem, is figuring out what we can pull out of
right.
it.
Right. Yeah, billing is a pretty big term.
Yeah.
There's a slice of what we call billing that you might be able to outsource.
So not all of it, probably?
Yeah, and it's not... like I say, billing has taken on a life of its own in terms of a
this
label.
This is billing for, like, everybody, right? The whole town, everything. You do all that?
For this... Quarterly
for sewer.
Yep.
You're chasing people down that aren't paying and all that stuff.
That's not included in that chunk of time.
No. So that's something separate.
That's something else.
So we've got a lot of work to do.
Yeah.
But if we didn't have a line item here, we wouldn't be able to do it if it did make sense.
Well, hopefully it works out.
I hope something works out.
Although Bob did just get a pretty sizable raise, so if it doesn't happen, whatever.
Well, there you go. Well, that's why we got to outsource it. It's too much money.
She's costing us too much money. It's costing us way more than this $25,000 to do billing right now.
Exactly. Right.
Good point.
Okay, legal counsel, we cut back because we've been pretty conservative.
I'm surprised it doesn't cut. When we see those legal bills, they're really not that high.
No.
So it's pretty good.
Copeland & Page has been doing a very good job for us, been very responsive and very efficient, you know,
sending us reams and reams of paper for a simple question, you know, just a simple email, and so...
Is that the town legal?
Yes.
Nice little plug you put in there.
There you go. Unfortunately, the selectmen can't hear it because they're interviewing legal companies right now. Engineering services.
All right. Is it 10,000? General consulting services.
Yeah.
And so it's 15, 10, and still 10.
Yeah. So we haven't really changed anything on that. And I'm not sure. We probably won't use it all this year.
So that would, again, that's another thing that would go into retained earnings if you don't use it all?
Exactly.
Is it anything that you don't use, you go into retained earnings?
Yeah. I mean, things get, if you get a huge bill, if things get moved around, so I will pull from line items that haven't had any activity, but at the end of the year, if those, if that money hasn't been used, it goes to retained earnings.
Okay.
And it's a good point, Joe, for your information. We, you know, we are able to move money around within the line items, you know, without going to a town. So there's a bit of that. You know, people may say, well, gee, that seems a little tight. What if a pump breaks? Well, chances are somewhere else there's going to be some overrun. There's overrunners all over the place.
Mr. Chairman, could I make a comment real quick?
Certainly, I'd be happy to break for Mr. Rogers.
The reason
come on up if you could come on up. You're used to introducing yourself.
Yeah, right. Dave Rogers, 82 Highland Street. The reason I'm here and asked to be heard is that I was watching this at home and I couldn't hear a thing. It was mumbled. I can't see anything on the TV. I mean, it was. So I said, "This is crazy. It's of zero value."
Yeah, well, thanks for letting me go. I mean, we didn't expect that people would be able to see this, so I'm not surprised at that, and there isn't much more we can do other than just not show it.
But the purpose, Mr. Chairman, I would think would be to give, you know, people like myself the opportunity to understand better what's going on, and it's just not coming through that way.
So I appreciate the volume. Is it in the sound room? Could we... Is it just me, or...?
Well, I think part of it is not speaking into the... It's, you know, one of these things, and not speaking into the microphone, you know?
Is this better in sound check, or...?
Well, you wouldn't know that unless you were at home.
They're in there.
Yeah.
Because I'm looking at this and speaking, but I'll try.
Well, I appreciate that.
The intent of this is primarily for the commission. There will be a public presentation of the budget to the Finance Committee on the 9th of March,
okay.
Which I would encourage anyone who is frustrated because they can't see the numbers to come to, and they can ask any questions that they would like,
okay.
And we can still change things. But to make this viewable by the public, I try to do that, and it would just take us all night because it would be so huge. So.
Yeah.
That's why we're trying to say all the numbers and tell the story. But if they can't hear it, that isn't working.
Yeah. And there's just no semblance to it. In fact, I couldn't tell you what the total budget is, how much is for you know, the various categories. I mean, there was a mention about taking notes. What's that about?
The minute taking.
Minutes, yeah.
That's a budget line item we have to get... help taking minutes, to actually take the tapes and create minutes for us.
Okay. You know, heretofore, hasn't Bob been responsible for that?
We actually had a position and the person left, so that's not a new thing. They had a position for that before, and the person left, and we're just trying to backfill it.
Really?
Yeah.
Right. Yeah, there was a part-time person in town who was doing it for us, and they went full-time, and then they could no longer do it. So we have someone else who's going to start doing it.
Full-time?
No. 15 hours a month,
okay.
Maximum.
All right. Well,
I appreciate your coming in, and I hope people can now. I'll try to speak over here. I don't know how to do any better.
I'll just make one last editorial comment, if I could. I think you said that. There was one lump figure for all of the contracts and that sort of thing. Is that right?
You may be referring to the INI?
There are a bunch of contracts that the sewer commission has, correct?
We have one, we outsource, we have several people we outsource to, but each is a separate line item. Small water, there's two for our pump, there's a pump station contract, there's a...
See, I caught that there was one large number, and that was made up of individual contracts that made, you know, the sewer department go. But I guess, and I don't want to take up any more of your time.
Okay, I appreciate it. John, maybe, or Barb, I'll tell you what, can we switch mics? That mic might maybe get closer to me, if it'll move over here.
On the 9th, is that, will the, yours be the only budget that is being heard?
There's usually two the same night, usually PAC is the same night, but I haven't seen the schedule, I've just been told that it's the March 9th is when we're on, but there's usually two that night.
Okay. All right. You don't happen to have an extra copy of the budget that you're going to act on tonight?
No.
No, okay. All right. Well, once you vote on it, would it be possible to get a copy of it?
Sure, certainly.
Okay.
Yeah, because once we vote on it, that's what we'll take to the Finance Committee.
Okay, I'll make sure that I stop down and ask for a copy of it. Thanks.
Great, thank you. Thanks for your input, Steve. Okay, hopefully this is easier to hear. So we just finished total purchase of services. I don't think there's any more conversation on that. Utilities, Barb, maybe the postage, I think we just reduced that a couple hundred dollars just based on the spend rate.
Right.
So I think it was like 24 or something last time you've seen it.
Right.
Any talk of going electric with the billing and stuff like that? You're talking about postage for billing and things?
Postage for, well, even for our
certified letters
to...
Restrap mailings.
Violations.
Okay. $2,200 for postage.
Yeah.
You know, email is free. Just throwing it out there.
That's a good point. We didn't look at it. That's why it's great to get other people to look at these. We more looked at
not for
spend rate.
Not for this budget, but maybe something we should look into is going electric.
Yeah.
Everything's paperless now.
We need to get 840.
Different emails. Yeah. Or make it an option at least for certain people maybe. Yeah. If you do the outsourcing of the billing, it might be, I wouldn't expect you to send 800 and something emails out, but it might be a way. Not for tonight, but.
No, it's good. Well, it's also the because that if we outsource, then part of that cost above the, that we talked about before is the mailing. For the mailings.
Yeah. All right. Electricity. 10 stations.
I think we reduced that a little bit,
mm-hmm.
Barb, just based again on the, what's the there was the expended to date, the column just before that is the expended to date through 7 months of the year.
Oh, okay.
So we basically said, we don't need 34,000 or 5 or whatever the number was. Okay.
And then diesel fuel, same thing. We used past usage to reduce that as well.
Yeah, basically. And it was just more...
Split in half.
Yes. Yeah. And again, if we're off by a couple hundred dollars, plus or minus, is killing your buddy. Miscellaneous. That's where all the money is.
Yeah, that's a large chunk. Right.
We reduced the professional meetings training that used to be 400 because we had an employee who had to have
certification and training, and that's gone away. So as you can see, we've only spent $40 so far.
We had an employee that needed training?
Yeah, the pump station maintenance used to be done internally.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Out of Jack's group, yeah.
Okay.
It needed to be certified.
Makes sense.
So we cut that in half, it probably can go less, but again, it's a small number.
Right, because of training, if there's training to be done.
Yeah, I've seen other trainings, it was Hannaford or something like that, did some training, was it?
Oh, that's training our customers for grease traps. I'm meaning like for me going to an Excel.
Oh, right, yeah, if you have to travel somewhere, do something like that.
Or enterprise fund training.
Are miles and everything included in, well, 200s, whatever. Probably not worth talking about it too much.
There is a mileage line below.
Oh, is there? I'm jumping again.
Yeah, no, it's good. You're getting us to the bottom.
I want to go right through 11. Capital costs.
The capital cost, John Fitch Highway, I've now... I now see the impact of not having the transfer out of stabilization above, right? Because that's what would offset this 18. So when we took that transfer out, we did impact the bottom line.
Yes.
So, do we want to put it back?
Thoughts? There's no wrong answer.
So were you saying which line out of it?
The capacity.
So the capacity.
The issue is if we're not billed, then we just transfer it back into.
Yeah, I guess, I guess there's an in-between ground that we could put on the table.
Are you talking about the 14,520?
Line 3B, the 10,285.
10,285.
The one we said that if we didn't have to pay, we wouldn't take it out. The in-between ground would be that we put it in here so it offsets at 18 and doesn't upset our bottom line. Mm-hmm. But unless we hear from Fitchburg before town meeting, we don't take it out of the...
No, this...
So what you could do that would cover all bases, you could leave this in here, like we had it originally before I messed it up. We can put a warrant in the town meeting to transfer that 10,285. Mm-hmm. If we don't hear... We could make the decision that if we don't hear from Fitchburg that the payment is come due or going to come due, then we pass over that warrant article.
Oh, okay.
By the May meeting?
By the May meeting, by the May 6th or 7th meeting.
Okay, but this is for FY18, so Fitchburg has a whole year to send us a warrant.
Yeah, and if we don't hear by town meeting, then we go to the plan A we had before that, and if they then notify us before our special town meeting, we go to special town meeting with that same warrant. And of course, at that time, it's going to be more money in there.
So you have like 10K just kind of in limbo until May?
You have 10K in this analysis.
Right, but we don't know where it's going yet.
If we don't get the $18,000 bill, then we don't transfer it in. So what'll happen is the $8,000, that's the difference, will end up actually falling out, you know, being more plus side to this budget.
But we're gonna get the bill eventually, right?
Yes, we will. But we've been doing this for a couple, 3 years now.
And they just don't bill us?
What's happened is the John Fitch was part of a much bigger project that they had. They had all this separation project. So
So John Fitch was one element of a massive plan they had. Until they finish all the work, they don't identify all the costs. They have to identify exactly the cost that's associated with John Fitch before they can bill us.
I got you.
So as long as they keep going with their project, the bill just keeps being on hold.
So we really don't know when we're going to get it?
We don't really know when we're going to get it.
It's going to happen eventually. That's why we have the money.
It's going to eventually happen.
Could we get an update before the May meeting? Could you ask Fitch,
We can certainly find out where they are with their project. Yeah, and that's what I'm saying. So if we left it like it is here and left that 10 in, we can get an update by the May meeting. Right. Look, where are you? You know, when do you expect to do it? And, you know, these things don't move quickly anyway. They'll probably be able to say, it's not going to be for 6 months or it's not going to be this year.
Right.
If they say it's going to be in fiscal 18, we've got the warrant article, we go pull it out. If they say, no, it's not going to be at least for 6 months, then we don't have to pull it out and we can wait till the next town meeting to pull it out.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm fine with that.
I'll leave it in.
Yep. Okay. All right, this is a good one. Capital costs. We had discussed briefly that someday we should really start talking about setting up a capital fund, because we are going to have, something's going to happen. We've got, we looked at that number, over $2 million worth of pump station equipment out in the world. Something's going to happen. This line used to be called Capital Costs Leominster, because we always run a risk due to our IMA that Leominster will come ask us for some capital because they had an upgrade. So we've been carrying $15,000 every year that I've been here. They've never come to us, and so it just falls out. What we're proposing here is that we start that capital fund, and just capital, whether it's Leominster, Fitchburg, fix a pump station, and that we put, and what we used here for starting place, because it fit in the budget, quite frankly, was 3% of revenue, and to set that we set aside this year 3% of revenue, and we actually establish, and we'll talk about the warrant article, we establish a capital stabilization fund, and every year we add to it. And we can, during the course of this year, before next budget season, we can decide how we want to decide how much we put in every year. And it could become, you know, a fiscal policy to set aside X percent of something to capital. So that's how we got to 26.5.
Okay.
And Leominster connection fees, I think we just corrected consistent with 11 connections.
I lost one.
Yep.
And there are no Fitchburg connections in our assumption of 11.
That's easy. So it's down 35,859.
Again, taking out high fields.
Right.
Reaction.
So effectively it's up some 20K or something. Okay. So what that does, and maybe people at home could actually read this, I don't know. So we have on the grand total is expenses of $840,174 and revenues of $843,833. So a net positive in the black of $3,658. Now, just to calibrate that, last year's budget, in fact, it's right over there, right, Bob? The 78,144? That's the right number?
Yes.
Yeah. So last year we were in the black a lot more, 78,000 in the black. This year we've done a couple things. We've got 25K for the bill outsourcing, and we've got the 26K for capital. So instead of carrying more to retained earnings in the plan, we're earmarking some of it for capital, and we're hoping to use some of that, which again, the outsourced billing, if we do that, that's mostly non-recurring. So that wouldn't hit us next year. So we're sort of using the remaining goodness to buy down some future costs. Okay. The rest of the story is in the debt service, and this now is the debt service of the initial betterments at Sewer the Town, plus our recent ones that we just completed, Pratt, Lakeview, and Pleasant View. And at this point, the projection, which is solid, pretty solid. Certainly, the debt service is solid. It's the 843 that we pay in for the outstanding debt, $843,548. And the revenue is $653,000, about $190,000 less. Now that's not an awful thing, because a number of people paid up front, which is why we have retained earnings. So we've got about 1.3 million retained earnings, which is primarily where that came from. So that's used to offset this 190. Before we make the presentation to Finance Committee, we'll project this retained earnings and debt service out. We did that last year, and it stayed positive through the entire term, so we didn't foresee a problem. I expect it to be a little bit better this year, but we'll have to run the numbers out. But I'm sure we'll stay positive.
Cool.
Is that it?
That's it.
That was easy.
It's easy for you.
Yeah, we got to talk about it twice.
Now, it's a good dry run for the Finance Committee.
Do we do a motion to approve these?
Yes, that would be wonderful.
All right, I propose a motion to approve the Sewer FY18 budget draft.
A second.
That.
Thank you, John. Any further discussion?
Nope.
None. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Thank you. Okay, moving on with the agenda.
There's more?
Yeah, I know. Not much more. Not much more.
I assume we all have to be present for the March 9th Finance Committee.
If you can, it's great.
The other parent is on the Finance Committee.
But, yeah, so...
So I think you definitely need.
I think you're covered. you did your duty tonight. It's nowhere near this level of detail. There's a lot more of the story of, you know, like our goals. We'll present the goals, what we accomplished, what we're planning for I&I. There's a lot of, you know, just telling the story around the budget.
Yep.
And a very summarized budget.
Yeah, if I can be there, I will.
Okay.
I know she definitely is going to be there because she's on the other side of it. But.
Right. She's got the inside track now.
Yeah. Now, yeah, now.
Okay. Next on the agenda is operations. We did receive the proposals. Hope everybody got the proposal from Weston and Sampson. Three elements of the proposals. One for the cammering of the Whalum area, one proposal for sewer manhole rehabilitation plan preparation and construction services, and then the third one for I think essentially, if I read this right, Bob, this would be essentially to support our required submittal in December to the state for INI reduction. So those three proposals, we can have whatever discussion you like tonight. I'd like to put that on the next agenda when we have at least our fourth member available. We do, it is timely, so I think the next agenda probably should focus on INI, because we do want to get some things going for the spring when the rains come. Any initial comments on this that we might want to feedback to? Although the only thing just is that there was a fourth task that we had asked Wes and Sampson to provide, and that was to calibrate our pump stations so that we might be able to use them as a rough estimate of the water of the flows. And they said that they're going to submit that. They didn't do that
actually, yet. Actually, Pat Cotton did call me right before I left and gave us, said it was about 2 days work and he could calibrate all 10 stations for $5,000.
Okay.
But he'll do a more polished proposal as far as what that covers.
Okay.
So.
Again, because
offered to come tonight, and I didn't think
yeah,
it was
yeah,
necessary.
No, we need to digest these and have some discussion, and probably have some discussion with Jack, quite frankly, before we take more of his time. But there might be interest, to save Pat and us some time, to get for that pump station calibration, what it would cost to calibrate. Each station independently would be good so that we can pick and choose, because there's certain pump stations that maybe doesn't make sense to calibrate because there's so little flow, there's three people on it. But certainly Dana Street is a huge one. We'd like to know how much it would cost for Dana Street. We may well find that Lemister Road might be another one. I'd have to look at the map, but I suspect we, when we get into the detailed discussion here, we may want to pick and choose and say we'll calibrate this one, or only this one. If he can give us some breakdown when he does this.
Hey, John? Might be a good idea to get the Dana Street pump calibrated before any of this work starts.
Right. Yeah, if you can give him that heads up. You know, how's his timing? If at our next meeting we took a vote to calibrate Dana, how quickly could he do it? Any other initial comments to feedback to Wes and Sampson about our extensive discussion on these?
I think it's pretty much what we talked about when Pat made his presentation.
So. Right.
Probably we should get some clarification as to exactly are all the pipes in the streets new in that area? Or is the clay pipe issue only coming from the house to the street?
Yeah, Barb, if you could get more of a Jack question, I guess if Jack could confirm where the clay pipes we're concerned about. Are they in the street or on people's properties? The other thing, more on that line, that the second task, which is the manhole rehabilitation, which is near and dear to my heart because it's work we can go do and make a difference. He talks about 10, as many as 10 manholes that they would do, and then estimates, you know, some money to work on those manholes. Which manholes, you know, is he or Jack selected those manholes, and based on what? It's out of you know, the 300 plus manholes we have, I'm wondering how we pick which 10.
I thought Jack had gone through the list and picked his high priority ones.
It should be identified, and you know, if they've been picked, it, you know, we should have that identified by Wes and Sampson which ones they are. And as many as, I'm not, it makes me nervous when I see as many as. Is it as little as, or is it 10 or not? Is it 10? Okay. Because again, we'd like to make, it'd be nice if we could make some decisions at the next meeting and not miss the season. Okay. Pump station reports. My only comment on the pump station reports, which isn't a surprise, is that the inputs that we had provided regarding what's still wrong with them hasn't been updated, so we still don't have the units for the Leominster Roads pump station still make no sense, and we still have a lot of negatives, and the works, the sheets, just the quality has to be addressed. But I think I sent you that email, Barb, maybe days before they submitted these, so I wasn't expecting miracles, but certainly the next one.
Okay. Make sure then. Yep.
And on that whole operations side, I'm going to say maybe it's coming up, but I don't want to steal your thunder.
On what? Annual report?
Annual report?
I was just checking my email. I had talked to Deb last week about getting it, and then today. Yep, so Susan Mooney did send it to me.
Good.
Archive, okay. But I will I'll just send it to everybody.
Yeah, great.
Okay. We have received it.
Okay. That's great. Yeah, I think the key thing that there may be something, maybe nothing, but one of the specific items that we request in the annual report is input on anything that they've seen that maybe we should be working on or fixing or buying or doing some upgrades to or whatever, because that could be relevant to our, you know, our budget and our planning. So that's the piece of the annual report that I'm anxious to see. Okay, town meeting warrants. Standard budget article, which is obvious, and once we get this approved, okay.
And now item three is the, but now we're putting, never mind, I'll take it, I crossed it off, but we're going to put it back in, so never mind.
Thanks.
That's just most recent conversation. Also with Jeff Blake, so.
Oh, good. Okay. Why don't you walk us through these in Burr?
Okay. The general budget article is the standard one once our budget is approved.
Mm-hmm.
Number two is the INI transferring. This is our, this two and three are both standard for our stabilization fund accounts, the sewer bank INI and the reserve capacity. To be able to transfer out of our budget and put them in a safe place for safekeeping so that it does not end up in retained earnings.
So, but this one we won't use this year, right? We're gonna take out of the INI, not put in.
Right, but the monies that, I know we went through this yesterday and I got myself all.
No, it's confusing, that's why.
I know. In order for it to be there for FY18, we have to somehow earmark it for the close of FY17. Or we could potentially, it would go to retained earnings. So this is a way to, we put it and then in a special meeting, we can transfer it back. But if we don't, if we use it, actually, that's what it is. So we have it if we need it, but if we haven't spent all of the INI that we're hoping to for this year, FY17,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Then we tuck it away and can transfer it back as needed, maybe in the special town meeting.
So when do we tie down the dollar value for town meeting?
Can, and that's why I wanted to say a sum of money, because last year we weren't able to transfer everything we had actually collected for INI. Mm-hmm. So it would be probably the week prior. Probably the week prior. I don't think, I think reserve capacity went through that way last year with a sum of money, and then it is determined at town meeting what the balance is in the account. If we name an amount in March, that's the amount that's going to be on the warrant, so we may still collect some monies for FY '17, but I'd rather hold. And then by May, we will know most likely whether we'll be able to spend that, and then we wouldn't want it, we don't have to transfer it out.
So do we, so it sounds like that the safest thing is we have two warrant articles, one to transfer in and one to transfer out. But at the end of the day, we'll only use one of them, right? I mean, we won't transfer in and out on the same day. Different amounts of money.
The one coming in is for FY 18. The one for out is holding on to FY 17. If it's not spent, we'll know by May whether we've got the contracts in line with Weston and Sampson to do the INI. And if we are going to spend the money, we don't have to transfer it out. Okay. So that one's to hold on to FY 17. The transfer in is so that after July 1st, we have that money to spend on INI going forward for that $50,000 that's in this budget.
So again, it seems like the most general thing is we have two warrants, one to transfer in and one to transfer out, but neither one of them has a dollar figure on them until the last minute.
I have the transfer in with the money because we have an established amount that's in those funds from the transfers last year. So that's actually four lumped together. Stabilization article to see if the town will vote to transfer from INI stabilization to the sewer enterprise fund the amount of $14,005, and from the reserve capacity stabilization fund to the sewer enterprise fund the amount of $10,285 for mm-hmm. use in FY 18. Now those could okay. be broken into two, but
that's whatever the town wants to do.
Have the money for FY 18. The other one is to preserve money that may not get used in FY 17 that we can. Again, like we were going to do with the other, the reserve capacity, just transfer it over if things come in.
Okay.
We'll see. I mean, Karen will take a look at it, and Heather, and so we'll see if we're.
That's why I said okay. I'm sure five people are going to look at this to make sure we get it right.
Right. And then the last one is the Chapter 40, Section 5, general law that we need to accept at town meeting in order to lien. Fees and charges. We had done it properly for our quarterly bills so that they may be put on our tax bills, but this is to lien any other charges and fees.
Okay.
And I did talk with Jeff, and he will have it to us by the end of the week.
Okay.
The only thing that would not be a we would not be able to do with that Chapter 40, Section 58 is fines. Fines are not covered under that chapter. And Jeff has issues with, I'm like, well, do we change our language? You know, is it as simple as that? And he said, no, a fine is by its own nature a fine, it's not a fee. So we still have that basically illegal connection or violations. That may not, we still will not have the ability to lien. Jeff's going to take a look at it, at our regs, pick it apart, see what we can do.
So is it your understanding right now that if we get this general law, whatever it is,
4058,
if the town accepts that through this warrant, that we would be able to lien properties for violations of the grease trap?
Yes, that's what I'm... He's going to take a look, because I have... We call them non-compliance fees now, the $50.
Right.
Jeff's going to take a look, but that's my feeling, is that's what we're going for.
Yeah.
But that illegal connection thing, we have to come at from a different angle. It's a criminal.
Okay.
It's more of a criminal.
The $25?
A date, yeah. When you said 50?
Yep. It's a fee. We call it a $25 a day fee, I believe. Yeah, that's another.
Okay, so we still got to get the final.
Yes, he should. He's going to take a look at, and he has our regs, and he's going to just look and make sure we're covered as to what we want to do.
Great.
Make sure.
So there's one more too then, right? Or is that our new capital stabilization?
Oh, right, did I skip it? Yes, a number 5.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yes.
The capital reserve, yep.
I misspoke.
We just went over.
So 4058 is for liens, and the 40 section 5 is our ability to create stabilization funds. So so number 5 is to see if the town will vote pursuant to General Laws 45 to create a capital reserve stabilization fund and to further to transfer from available funds a sum of money into capital reserve.
Great.
This is to create that 26.5.
Right, just start with that.
Mm-hmm. It's the ability to create a fund to put it somewhere.
Okay, good. Yeah, I didn't see that one. So that's wonderful. I'm glad there aren't more than 6. We'll run us out of, run me out of town at town meeting. Okay, that's wonderful.